DTG device package installs with three Q groups. There's a group for white shirts, which has a fast and a quality queue. The white shirt queues are the only queues that are not set up for specific fabric types. There's a group for black shirts, which has a queue for black synthetic shirts and black cotton shirts. And finally, a queue for color shirts, where there's a queue for colored cotton shirts and colored synthetic shirts. All queues in the DTG device package use layers and processing options to allow users to directly import designs into the RIP. If you double-click a queue, you can navigate to the layer profile and see that there's two layers for this queue. An underbase layer, which only has the white channel enabled, and the color layer, which has CMYK and white enabled. Each layer has its own processing options that can be changed to work best on your shirts. To import a design, go to File, Import File, choose the design, and select Open. A template dialog box will appear. This shows because all the DTG queues are set to use templates. Unless importing multiple images into different template slots, you can hit Express. The templates are based on the DTG platens that DCS offers. You can change the template for the queue, but can only do it if there are no jobs in the queue. Once the image loads, you can scale, move, or rotate the image to get it in the proper position. View raw data is a valuable tool to ensure your design is going to print correctly on your shirt, but it can only be selected after the job is ripped. Right-click and hit Rip Only. Right-click the job and select View Raw Data. The View Raw Data allows you to see individual channels and where the ink will print on multiple layers. Here we can select View as Black, deselect all channels, and just select the white that prints on layer 1. We can see that the RIP has automatically applied a white underbase to our image. The black shirt queues are unique due to the fact that they have the Knock Me Blackout feature enabled. If we import an image with a black background, we can see that the RIP automatically eliminates all the black in the image. If we view the raw data, we can see that the black and the white underbase are removed from the file. This will allow the black of the shirt to show through in these areas. Designs imported into the white shirt queues will obviously not have a white underbase applied. However, they do print clear ink, so it is important to only use images that have transparent backgrounds. Here we can see that the clear ink is going to print in the entire square of the JPEG. Bringing in a PNG file that has transparency will eliminate the clear from printing in the entire bounding box.